Of hydrocarbons, just like in ordinary physical chemistry or any other aspect of chemistry apart from organic chemistry, reactants are the major things we deal with. So also we have in organic chemistry. So there are some basic form of chemical reactions that are peculiar to them. So they share some with other aspects, but there are some that are peculiar to hydrocarbons. And there are some that are also peculiar to organic compounds. Is that a thing? Now, we need to start from the word hydrocarbon itself. So we already know that. So from here, that we are going to see that any compound, that is any organic compound, will be looking at its reaction here, will be in form of hydrocarbon. Is that a thing? So our hydrocarbon, as we know, it can be alkane. It can be alkane. Then it can be alkyne. So aside from these three, the other one we can have aromatic hydrocarbon. Benzene, aromatic hydrocarbon. So, other form of aromatic compound may not be hydrocarbon. For instance, phenol is aromatic compound, but it is not a hydrocarbon, or it has another element apart from carbon and hydrogen. So, this one is phenol. It is not part of aromatic hydrocarbon. Why? Because of this one. So now, alkane, aromatic hydrocarbon, benzene, and some other one that does not involve any other different element apart from hydrogen and carbon. So basically, from some of our previous lessons, we
started a note or a case to this particular one. Reactors of a case. So it's one of the first one here, combustion reaction. So it's one of what we are going to look at. Combustion of hydrocarbons. So, of which alkane is one of them. So what about that of alkane is the time? So combustion simply means what? When your reaction takes place in the presence of oxygen. When your reaction takes place in the presence of oxygen, or a reaction that needs oxygen to take place, is what we call combustion reaction. So combustion of hydrocarbons generally give us two products that you can see here, carbon dioxide and water. Then it is generated along with it. Meaning that combustion of hydrocarbons are basically the form of an exothermic reaction. Combustion of hydrocarbons. Why? Because it is generated, it is produced along with those main products. So for alkane, we have this general equation for it. CnH2n plus 2, that's for alkane. Then with oxygen. So look at the coefficient we have for oxygen here. 3n plus 1 divided by 2. So this is true for any form of alkane, whether big or small. I think regardless of the size of our alkane, as long as it contains covalent bond throughout, it must obey or it must fall in with this general formula for combustion. So if you are able to memorize this formula, there's no problem. So that means you are very free to do that, and then we find any equation on it very easy to balance. Meanwhile, you can also do that balance your parallel method. So you can swear, and you hope you see. So if you are giving something like this, C7H16 plus oxygen to give CO2 and H2 plus heat. So if I don't want to use plus heat here, I can simply do something like this. Minus N, that is what? That reaction is what? It means what? The reaction is exothermic. When the pH is negatively charged, is that the key? So this one should mean that this reaction is exothermic. Any reaction that you see on the product side, it is added. It means that the reaction is exothermic. So now to balance this one, we say we have to find our N is 7, isn't it? Plus 1 divided by 2. So that would be the coefficient here. For CO2, the coefficient is that our N, that is 7. For water, N plus 1, that's 7 plus 1. That is it. So this one, 21 plus this one, 22 over 2, that is what? So that means we are putting 11 here. So now let's all check if the equation is balanced. It's balanced. Carbon is 7 here, carbon 7. Then this oxygen here, 14 plus oxygen here, 8. That's 22. This is oxygen, 11 by 8 is 22. Hydrogen 16, 8 by 2. So if you change it as well, you have another. Okay, yeah. free and what? And wait. So we put the same thing. So we are going to have a 3 plus 1. Set it. 3 times 1. Then plus 1 divided by 2. For carbon, 3 air. Oh, sorry, 3 times 3, thank you. Then for water, n plus 1, that's 3 plus 1. So we have 4 air, 3 air. So for this one, this is 10 plus 3 times 3 is 9 plus 1, that's 10. And you have 5. So let's check if it is balanced. Is it balanced? Now, so that is for conduction reaction pertaining to alkanes. So this one is just yes. It's not possible. That's what we are saying. It's not possible. You make use of the formula. You are giving the equation. It's time for you to balance it. You understand? It's not possible. We can use our trial and error method that we normally use to balance any chemical equation. By the end of the day, we will still arrive at the same thing. So, it means that if you can make efforts to understand that formula, it will make your work easier rather than trying to use trial and error method. Is that the thing? So, that is for our case. Then another major reaction that alkanes undergo is what we call substitution reaction. And from the name, we know what it means. We are replacing certain thing with another one. We are substituting one for the other. So alkanes. So, why? Substitution. It's not pertaining to the other two alkanes, alkynes, no. But alkanes only. What is the reason? Can someone tell me? Yeah, what? They are said to be saturated compounds. They are said to be saturated compounds. Every carbon atom in any alkane is fully filled with a maximum number of every carbon matter we are paying is fully filled with maximum number of single covalent electrons. So as a result of that, if anything needs to be added or coming into that formula, then there should be replacement or there should be displacement of one thing from that alkane. There should be displacement of one thing from that alkane. So under substitution reaction, we now have different types. One of it is halogenation. Halogenation, that is halogen reacting with alkanes. It now gives a lot of other things. So I put it as number under two. Halogenation usually takes place in the presence of UV light. Or to a toilet light, or you can use it to
the way photosynthesis needs sunlight energy before it can occur. So allocated usually means external factor as a catalyst, and that is light. So addition of halogens or reaction of halogens. With alkanes. So for instance, the simplest alkane that we have is this. What about this one? Alkene. This is alkene, this one. You say what? It's an alkyl group. Thank you. This one is an alkyl group. So the simplest hydrocarbon that can exist and can stand on its own is that one that we have under alkanes. So this is the simplest alkane and the simplest hydrocarbon that we have. This one cannot stand on its own. So it is never regarded in the simplest hydrocarbon. So that's why we always do something like this. Or at most, we put dots here. Like Arabica, still looking for something to be attached to. Or methane, being the simplest alkane, can stand on its own as a compound. And as a result of that, it is the simplest organic compound that we can have. Simplest organic compound, the simplest hydrocarbon, and at the same time, the simplest alkane that we have. That is methane, CH4. So, with halogen, chlorine, for instance. So, what we have on, our CH4 is normally drawn like this. This is our CH4, our methane. So what we have with chlorine in the presence of UV light as a catalyst is that two of these, if you want to just write a single equation for it, the two chlorine atoms will displace two hydrogen atoms. So these two hydrogen atoms will come out as hydrogen gas. So here we have a chlorine atom, another chlorine atom. Just a simple equation. So this one can be written in such form like this: CH2Cl2 plus this one, CH2. You want to solve your equation step by step, you're allowed to do so. So that is why this particular reaction is said to be a form of chain reaction. But the reactor can still go further. The presence of excess halogen. For instance, I have two molecules of chlorine reacting with a molecule of methane. So I'm going to have all the hydrogen atoms being replaced. So I'm going to have this one. I hope you are following it. So this one is CCl4 plus 2H2. We provided the name to this one during our last lesson, CCl4. I put it on the first place. Those of you that you copy the name, you have it in your notes. You say what? Carbon tetrachloride. Carbon tetrachloride. Or? Yes, tetrachloromethane, because it's been derived from methane. This is the originator of that compound, methane. So we replace four hydrogen atoms in methane with chlorine atoms. So that's why you can simply call it tetrachloromethane. Is that okay? So your reaction in stepwise manner, you are going to have four different equations. In stepwise manner.
but this is a single equation for it. If you have CH4 plus CN2, you have CH3 CN plus HCN, that's one. Then this one continues here plus CL2. So what are you going to have? CH2 CL2 plus HCA. Is the equation balance? Okay, yes. Now we move on CH2 CL2 plus chlorine to give CH CL3 plus HCA. And the last one, how we arrive at this one? So, CHCl plus Cl2 plus HCl plus HCl. So that is why we say it's a form of chain reaction. So the reaction will continue as long as we have our halogen in excess. That's how we continue to give us these last products, tetrachloromethane. So question can come. In excess halogen, the final product of its reaction with alkane is, so everything, all the hydrogen atom in alkane will be replaced with that halogen. Is that taking all the hydrogen atoms will be replaced? So we should take note of that. So now another form of substitution reaction is what we call nitration reaction. That is addition of nitro compound. Nitro, that is just NO2. So this time round, it is not nitrogen 4 oxide. Not nitrogen 4 oxide. Okay. So for instance, when we have our methane as well, so with look at that compound. H-O-N-O-2. You can write it as this. Nitric acid. Also nitrate 5 acid. Isn't it? This one. Well, it's being broken down in this way just for you to see how the reaction goes. Is that taken? Being broken down in this form. H-O to N-O-2. To see how the reaction goes. So what we are going to have here is that this NO2 is phase one of the hydrogen atom. Okay. So we are going to have CH3 NO2. Is that taken? CH3. Are we together? Hey, uncle. From here, look up everybody. One hydrogen atom is being replaced or is being substituted here. So we are going to have CH3, then NO2 will come in. Is that taken? So the hydrogen atom, one from here, three, the one we are taking out, we combine with this one. So now give us what? Are we together? That one give us what? Eh? Why is this one? Eh? Water, you don't know. So the reaction can continue like that in stepwise manner, just like this one too. Which one is that? You mean for this? Oh, yes, sir. So this is what we call nitration reaction. So nitration reaction, so it's a form of substitution reaction. So it's something stand on its own. So it's one that substitution reaction. Is that taken? Two from hallucinant. That's why I try to explain it. Okay. I hope we are putting the notes down.
or the Jotins. Now, the other parts, that is the other monocle series on hydrocarbons, alkanes. Alkanes also undergo this one. We are going to see, so we look at half of alkanes. Now, alkanes as well. First thing on this one, we need to know the general molecular formula for alkanes, just as we learned under alkanes. We start again. Under our comprehensive chart for the list of hydrocarbons, we have it here. General molecular formula for alkanes. The functional group here, we've been using it, starts with our number, that's double bond. Is that taken? And we arrive at the name. How we arrive at the name? Methane. If we say we have methane for alkanes, we have methane. Are we saying we are going to have methane for alkane as well? Are we going to have methane for alkane? A-N-E-E-N-E. You say no. Why? Why are we not going to have this? Then if we are talking of alkanes too, are we going to have methane? Yes? Yes, no, yes. Can you explain yourself? No, can you explain yourself as well? Yes?
Yes.
Yes, why? Okay. When we are naming them. Okay. It ends with A-N-E. So that means for our case, we end with D-N-E, isn't it? Then Y-N-E. Oh, okay. Thank you. Ali, she was able to support the answer with a reasonable explanation. Well, let's see whether that explanation can be taken as being correct. Oh, it's reasonable explanation for it, because the name is changed. We don't change A-N-E with D-N-E with Y-N-E with O-N with A-N and so on and so forth. So that's why I said reasonable explanation for our answer. Yes, come. You say what? Alkanes are double bond, okay. There's only one carbon in anything we call met. Anything, any compound that has met as its prefix. M-E-T-H as its prefix. Stands for one carbon atom, isn't it? Okay. Thank you. You can sit down. Those who know, you can sit down. So, if this is number of carbon atom, one carbon atom, one carbon atom, so we are going to add it at this, and we can conveniently draw its structure, that is CH4, one carbon atom. This one, isn't it? This is for CH4. So for this one, one carbon, so how do we write it? Am I going to say four as well? Three? Two? Why? How do you arrive at two? Okay, the formula CnH2n. This one is CnH2n plus 2. CH2. So how do I draw the structure for this one? This one carbon, yes, hydrogen. How do I place my hydrogen? Like this? See, will it be like this? For CH2. Do you agree with this one? You don't agree with it. Why is it wrong? Why is the drawing not correct?
Yes, Roy. You said? You said metals? It's meant to have one double bond.
No, it's, that is not true. Your last assignment,
yes, we have double bonds. Two double bonds. Diene, you can have diene, you can have triene, you can have tetraene. One double bond, two double bonds.
The drawing is not correct. So why is it not correct? So that is the reason.
Okay, yes. Because we can't have. We can't have double bond between carbon and another element. Well, I give you 50%, but it's not 100%. Yes, you are actually right. So we cannot have the reason why this diagram is not correct. Your hydrogen is the reason here. Hydrogen cannot take from double bond. Have you ever seen a place where hydrogen takes from double bond before? Or you have hydrogen one year. You can never see a place or any drawing where you have hydrogen like this or hydrogen like this. You start thinking, it is the hydrogen that is the cause of the problem here. So this hydrogen and this one. So now you can have between carbon and other elements, double bond. Is that okay? Alkanoic acid. Alkanoic acid. CO. So that's the functional group. So we have it like this. Remember, that's COH. So it can be between carbon and other elements. But not to hydrogen. So hydrogen here, look at the hydrogen here. The single bond. So it cannot take on double bond or having single bond at both sides. If hydrogen has only one what? Only one electron. Isn't it? Hydrogen has only one electron. If you follow this thing like this, you are saying that hydrogen can take two electrons, which is totally wrong. Is that the thing? Now, there's no compound like this. There's no compound like this. If this is methane, so we now say we should have methane. So there's no compound like methane. Similarly, there's no compound like methane. We go by the formula here, minus two. So we are going to have a. How do we go to, we have C, then H0, no hydrogen. Is it? Yes. No hydrogen. So that means it's no longer hydrocarbon itself. Eh? So that means this one seems to be hydrocarbon. So there is nothing like methane, nothing like methane. It's only methane. So that is why I said earlier on, that's why I said earlier on that methane is the simplest alkane. Is that the case? Methane is the simplest alkane. Methane is the simplest hydrocarbon. Methane is the simplest organic compound. Is that okay? But what about the simplest, if I ask you the simplest alkane that we can have, or that can exist? What? Ethene, thank you. C2H4. So it's the simplest alkane
that we can have. C2H4, that is 18. And similarly, for this one, C2H2, going by this formula. So the simplest alkyne is what? Alkyne. Is that the thing? Why can't you say what? Betting. I will just prove it now. So you are not there at all. We just prove it now that there's no way you can return the formula. There's no way you can draw the formula or write the formula. It doesn't work with the ideas of chemistry. It doesn't work. Look at this one now, only carbon. For if you want to say you have methane carbon, then it's no longer hydrocarbon. Then it seems to be under organic chemistry. This one too, CH2. So I'm trying to draw the structure. This is what I can come up with. And of course, hydrogen can never take double bond like this. Hydrogen can never take single covalent bond on both sides. Just one time. Hydrogen has only one electron. Yes, your question is. Okay, thank you. Now, so let's make progress. So now, hello. So, naming of alkenes. So, it's similar to what we've done under alkenes. Of course, we name some alkenes even as part of our work. So, we don't need all this one, isn't it? We've done something like this. So, this is where we are going to. Chemical properties of alkenes. So, as in reactants, we have under it. Combustion reactants as well. So, combustion reactor for alkenes. So, we have the general formula as well, if you need it. It's not compulsory that you go by it, you can work out it on your own. Is that okay?
Yes.
So if we have C4H8 plus oxygen, we all know the two products, carbon dioxide and water, isn't it? Then plus what? So you can balance it on your own. And use your trial and error method to balance it. You don't want to go by their formulas. So carbon is 4 here, so you put 4 here, isn't it? Hydrogen 8, so I can put 4 here, hydrogen 8, oxygen. Oh, I have 2 here. I even have more than 2 already here. So I already have 8 here. It's 4, that's 12. So to turn 2 to 12, multiply by 6. So I put it here. So now you can now check it with the formula. Is this equation compatible? Does it go along with the formula? Yeah. Okay, so we say CN. So 2N. So from here, 4 times what? So that is 3 times 4 divided by 2, isn't it? 12 over 2, that is 6, isn't it? Then here we have our N as usual, 4. Then for water, we have just N as well. So that means this one is even very straightforward, unlike that of alkenes. So what are we expecting under alkynes? The third one. Are we expecting similar things? C for H for alkynes. So this is butene or butane rather. This is butane, isn't it? This one is butene. Isn't it? This is butane with O2. So give CO2 plus H2O. Okay. Now, let's try to balance it. Carbon 4, hydrogen 6. I put 3 here by 2, 6. Oxygen, I only have 2 here, no problem. But here, I already have 8 with what? 3. That is 11. So get 11 from 2. 11 over 2, thank you. Yes, that is a smart student. 11 over 2. O2. Yes. Multiply 2 by 2, so it gives us 11 atoms of oxygen. Is that taken?
Yes.
So this is for alkyne as a homologous series. So now, can we on our own generate a formula for combustion of alkynes? Eh? Can we generate a formula on our own? Yes. So tell me what to write. Cn Hn minus 2 plus 3n minus 1 over 2 O2. Okay. N CO plus. You said what? N minus 1. H2O. Okay. Can we check it? See if that is actually right. 3 by 4, for instance. Yeah, that's 12 minus 1, 0 over 3. Okay. Then here, N minus 1, that's 4 minus 1, that's 3. Okay, let us come up with another formula for alkyne. Let's say we have, what is it?
Okay,
but this one is coming out. If you don't, now, give me another chemical formula for alkyne. Any alkyne member again? Anyone? Yes. C5H8 plus O2 to give CO2 plus H2O. Now, let us apply this formula now. C5H8. So we say 3 times 5. Minus 1 over 2. Isn't it? 3 times 5, that is what? Minus 1. 14 divided by 2. We have 10 here. Then here, we have 5. So at this place, 5 minus 1, that's 4. So let's check it out. Let us check it, see if the equation is balanced. Is the equation balanced? Is the equation balanced? Okay. Thank you. So, that way on your own, you can see we can come up with the. So, those formula you are seeing there, it doesn't get there by miracle. It's something you can do extra work on your own. You can do extra work on your own. You get all these things very easily. Okay. Now, addition reaction now. Under alkenes. We are done with this one. Under our case, we thought about substitution reaction as the second major reaction, isn't it?
But here now, we are talking about addition. That is, product of adding something to that our original compound. We are not substituting now, or we are not replacing it, but we are adding to it. So you are not taking anything out of the existing compound. Rather, we are adding to it. Is that okay? For instance, here we made use of halogens, other substitution reaction with alkanes. We can also talk about halogenation here, under addition reaction, halogenation of alkanes. But it seems to be substitution reaction as we have it under alkane, but rather addition reaction here. For instance, if you have something like this, the simplest alkane is what? The simplest alkane. Let's say we have this for ethene with chlorine gas as a form of halogenation. So what are we going to have? We are going to have this compound. How will the structure look like? Look at it here. From here, we have it like this. So our chlorine gas, CN. So now, coming to this side, these two carbon atoms, 1, 2, is that taking my hydrogen? Let me supply it first. These two chlorine atoms here, one here. So this is C2H4Cl2. You say? Yes, it has disappeared.
Why?
Because of this one. We add on to it. Not that we are substituting or replacing. It's meant to be in Nostri 1, I think. Nostri 1. Daniel, we're going to go back to Nostri 1. Are we together? Look at this. This one coming here, the second one coming here. They are fast. This particular molecule plays on this. We turn this double bond to single bond. Okay, give me the first one. This one. Are we together? So C2H4Cl2. What is the name of this compound? Can someone try to name it? This one, this is the structure. Okay, one dichloroethane, because there's no double bond here. So good. 1,2-dichloroethane. 1,2-dichloroethane. Now, another possible product that we can have, different from this one. Hello, one house. We still have C2H4 plus Cl2. Another student can decide to draw it on our own this way. Look at it.
Is it too late?
What is the problem? Okay. Do we agree with this particular structure as well? So this is another possible product that we can have from halogenation of alkanes. So what is the name of this one?
No.
Okay, this is the one I've just finished explaining. For this first one, I'm just trying to explain it. Now, what about if it is a form of hydrogenation? Just like hydrogenation, that is addition of water, hydrogen. So, our hacking.
Okay, sir, I'm not going to replace, you are going to add.
Add, yes, you are going to add. So, the double bond will disappear. Eh? The double bond we have there will disappear. So, what are we going to add? We have H6. So, this is our ethane to ethane. Isn't it? Ethane to ethane. So, this is how we are now going to add this structure. So, that means when we hydrogenate alkanes, we are going to have alkanes. So, that is the simple meaning. Alkanes, yes. With excess hydrogen, it can come to alkane directly. Okay, alkane. No. It's fully saturated. Are we together? Now, what about if it is C3H6 plus hydrogen? So, what are we going to have? C3H8. No, it has turned to alkane here. So, this is propane. And this is propane, isn't it? Now, by instance, now let us look at the third one. If it is alkane, let's start from the simplest. C2H2 plus hydrogen. C2H4. Yes, good. So if you have more hydrogen, let's say, okay, from here now, we can now continue.
Is that taken? Are we together? Now, in a single inflection point, you can add your two here. And what will this one be? Let me go back. That is the first one. C2H2+2HG will give C2H6. Is that taken? This one is what? This one is more active. So this is 18. And this is. Thank you. And the two of them. Can someone tell us the difference between these two equations? You said what? XX hydrogen. Thank you. That is hydrogenator of anions. The presence of XX.
Stop. 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 St is on recording. They watch it back.
Okay. Now. IT man, come. Emma, bro, it doesn't change again. Next slide. He does not respond. Now, hello. If you need this particular slide too, you can take note of it. Yes. Halogenation, of course, I've explained it. So, but you need to take note of the note below it. Addition of bromine to hydrocarbon is a useful reaction to test them. One else, please. To test what? To differentiate between saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbon. Hey. Addition of bromine, or what we call bromine water, to hydrocarbons. But since we say addition, that means it cannot exist, or it does not work for alkanes, but only alkenes and alkynes. Is that taken? So we use this particular reaction to distinguish between saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. So during the process, the bromine color will disappear. And unsaturated hydrocarbons. No, you have no gases, the first four. The first four carbon hydrocarbons in all these homologous series, alkanes, they are gases. So you may not be able to say, oh, this is gas. This gas A is ethane or ethene or ethane. Since all of them are in gas form. So, but if you pass them into what is known as bromine water, any of the gas into bromine water, if the color of bromine water is discharged, that means it can either be ethene or ethane, one of the unsaturated. But if the color remains, then it is alkane. Then we go for further tests. You understand? But first thing, we'll be able to say, oh, it is alkane. It is not alkane. Then you now need to know whether it is ethene or ethane. Then we go for further tests. So there is another test to distinguish between the unsaturated. Is that taken? Can I change the slide? Okay. Hydrohalogenation. So addition of okay. Now hurry up with this side too. We have a class activity to do together to end this lesson. You say what? Yes. Because you wasted my time at the beginning of the lesson. We are okay, we are stopping on this slide 50. Hello, one house, slide 50. Now let's go to classwork quickly. We are doing it together. It does not matter. Me too, I'm hungry. But my own is even badly hungry. Yes, I didn't. Yes. Okay, so let's quickly look at this class activity. Question one. Rihanna, reach for us.
Oh.
Okay, now, so what is the answer here? Biology student.
Biology.
Yes. That means they have privilege over non-biology student to know this particular one. Okay. Good. Fermentation. Thank you. Number two. Benzene. Number three. So number three is what? Which of the following substances is used as an anesthetic? So you should find, yes. B. Okay, good. B is correct. So one of the products that is produced during the chain reaction of alkanes, that is halogenation of alkane. So that is trichloromethane. Trichloromethane. What about the next one? Question four. How many isomers can be obtained from C4H10? Two isomers. Can you name them? Can you name them, the isomers? The two isomers from C4H10. Two what? Two methylpropane, that's one. And butane, thank you. Number five. Six. Number six. A time. So we are calling it a day here. Yeah? Thank you for disturbing my class today. I'm not going to be able to do that.